What's going on, guys? It's Ethanol here, and this is the top 10 tower glitches in Destiny. So in this video, I'm going to go in depth on how to do each specific glitch as much as possible so you guys can get the full understanding of how to do them. I'm going to be ranking them from a 10 to 1 scale of difficulty, 10 being the easiest to 1 being the most difficult. Hope you guys enjoy. If you do, please leave a thumbs up, that would be great. And without further ado, let's do this! Coming in at number 10 is the levitation glitch. Now this glitch is fairly simple and pretty cool to do. You can do it virtually anywhere in the tower and you can trip out all your friends. Basically what you'll need to do is you'll need to go and find this purple floating ball. It'll spawn either next to the Cryptarch or the Bounties vendor. You then need to take the ball to a flat surface wherever you want, so anywhere in the tower. You can hit the ball in the air. And once the ball starts to come down, you want to jump perfectly on top of it. And hopefully it should start to glitch out a little and it should hold you in place. Sometimes the ball will float away and leave you levitating. Sometimes it'll stay underneath you, glitching about. Either way, it's pretty cool. You can trip out your friends with it and it's fairly simple. Coming in at number 9 is the vault glitch. Now this glitch is a little bit more difficult as there is a bit of parkour involved. I suggest you make sure you max out your agility on your character and use weapons that grant bonus agility like Mitre Multi-Tool or any of the raid weapons. So to do this glitch, you need to head over to the left hand side of main area and climb up the stairs to reach these few set of crates you see. You want to jump on the first set and then jump over to the second set, which will be next to a larger set of crates. From there, you want to face the wall and hug it real close. Then you want to jump to the left, keeping your face facing against the wall, and you should end up on top of the large set of crates. From there, you can jump onto the railing, and you'll want to quickly line yourself up with the pole facing the vaults, as you will get a timeout zone here. Once you're lined up, you want to sprint forward and spam the jump button continuously. You should start to fly and be able to land on top of the vaults. Don't freak out when you start to time out from flying, just keep spamming jump and let go when you know you'll land on top of them. Coming in at number 8 is the hidden hangar area glitch. In this glitch, you want to head over to the tower hangar to the right of where you spawn in, and you want to head over to the Pike ship lady. From there, you want to jump onto the small ledge just to the right hand side against the fence, and you want to jump on top of the notice board thing next to her. Once you're on top of that, you want to position yourself on an angle facing the gap at the top of the fence. You'll see a little gap at the very back of the top fence. From there, you want to jump over the top of that and you should fall down onto the floor of the hangar. From there, you want to slide past this weird looking gas tank thing and follow it all the way around the corner, and you can then get underneath the main hangar area and chill out. This is a very cool spot as it's a very open spot. There aren't really any other glitches that are as open as this one. You can use this area as a cool little hangout spot for you and your fire team. Coming in at number 7, and I'll call this number 6 as it's kind of a 2-in-1, is the fence glitch. Now, for this glitch, you'll need a friend to help you, and you want to head back over to the tower hangar again. And there are a few spots that you can do this, each being even more interesting. The first spot is just as you arrived in the tower hangar, and it'll be to the left as you come down the first set of stairs. To do this, you basically want to just hug the corner of the fence and keep jumping on top of each other. Eventually, you should end up on top of the fence. From here, you can get down to the previous glitch also, and there are a couple of other places you can do this. Most interesting would have to be this last spot, as once you get over the fence, you have to sort of feel your way around until you can start to walk forward. From here, you want to be very careful not to touch the wall to your right. You just want to keep going forward until you reach this support beam that sticks out. You want to angle yourself and slide around it, trying not to touch it as much as possible, as it will kill you immediately. Once you're past that, you can walk out to this opening, which has a pretty sweet view to enjoy. Coming in at number 5 is the bottom of the reef glitch. Now, this glitch is in the reef and it's pretty simple. All you need to do is head straight forward as you spawn in, and you want to jump down this little gap. This can be a bit tedious as you need to fall through a specific point, which can be hard to get exact. But yeah, once you get it, you fall all the way down to the bottom of the reef, which is pretty cool. You can look up and see everything, and yeah. The only downside to this is you can't walk forward, otherwise you will die. Coming in at number 4 is the pillar glitch. Now this glitch is very similar to the vault glitch. You do the exact same thing to get onto the top railing, but instead of running off the side, you want to run all the way up the pole until you reach the large shade. You need to spam your jump button as you run up the pole, otherwise it will not work, you will fall off. Once you're on the shade, you want to line yourself up with a specific branch on the large tree and jump onto it. After that, you want to jump on these next two branches and then make your way as high up as you can on the last branch. Once you're up the very top, you want to aim for the pillar to your left and jump on top of it. This one can be a little difficult as you need to be very precise to do it, but once on top, it's very cool to overlook the main tower area.
Cool. Oh, yeah, yeah. We do one for the reef as well.
Yeah.
From like the top of the thing.
Dude. Oh my god, I made it to the pigeon pole from that one. I jumped it.
What?
I jumped that gap.
Oh my. How?
I just went for it.
Oh my god, that's sick.
Coming in at number 3 is the camera glitch. Now, this glitch is located in the tower north and is a bit difficult. What you want to do is you want to head over to the right as you enter the tower north, and you want to jump on top of this sort of ledge thing. From there, you need to be very specific with how you position your character. You want to try and center yourself with this camera and jump on top of it. The hitbox on the camera is so small, so try and get a feel for it. Eventually, you should get it. Once on top, you want to angle yourself to jump on top of this arch thing. Once on top, you need to immediately sprint off and spam the jump button, like how we did with the vault glitch. From there, you want to try and land on this shade and go as far down as you can, otherwise you will time out. This spot is a pretty cool spot as it's a bit more difficult, but it's very confusing for your friends as they will have no idea how you did it. You can actually go a bit further up, as you see I will try to do, but I do fall off. It's not much different. You want to just spam the spam jump as you go up the shade and aim for the top corner. Just a bit higher of a spot and you won't time out. Coming in at number 2 is the tree pillar fly glitch. Didn't really know what to call this one as it's a messy one. So what you want to do is head over to the small tree to the right as you spawn in and jump on top of it. If you don't know how to get on top of it, just give it a go. It's pretty easy. You'll see me do it. Once inside the tree, you want to jump on top of this specific branch as you will see me do. You then want to carefully jump across to this second branch. Do not sprint jump as you will most definitely overshoot it. Once on the second branch, you want to make your way up as high as possible and position yourself to jump for the end of the pillar where it lips down. Once you get on the pillar, immediately sprint forward off the end of the pillar and spam the jump button. Once you start flying, you want to aim for the balcony that hangs off the hangar area entrance. Try and land further down on it, as if you land higher up, you will time out and die. This glitch is very difficult due to how specific it is, but it's very cool. And of course, number one of the most difficult glitches I have ever done is the top of the reef glitch. Now, this glitch is so specific and has a lot of steps, and if any of them stuff up, you need to do it almost entirely again. So, what you want to do is, as you spawn into the reef, you want to head next to the banner for the Eververse vending machine. You want to line yourself up with the railing and slowly scale up the wire. Once you reach the top, you want to slowly shift your character to the left until you see your character be lifted up slightly. From there, you want to face the gap on this bit of metal and try and land in between the gap. Once inside the gap, you need to climb up this specific pole, but don't go too far up as you will slip off and you will die. Once you are as high as you can go, you want to jump on this small metal pole to the left of you. Once on that pole, you want to make your way up and jump on this cog-looking thing. Try not to jump too close as it will bonk your head and you will fall off. Once on the cog, you want to aim for that bit of black, which looks like rubber, and jump on that. From there, you want to jump on that lip that sticks out to the right, and then jump to your left on the little bit of blue metal. Now, this last jump is probably the hardest. You want to jump straight across to the same bit of metal, being very careful not to overshoot it. Do not sprint jump. Once you're on that bit of metal, you can then jump to the very top, and voila, you are now on top of the world. This glitch is so hard, but so, so satisfying and cool once you do it. Well, there you have it. That's the top 10 reef and tower glitches in Destiny. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, please leave a like. That always helps out. And once again, have a great day, Guardians, and I'll catch you guys later.